Submacular hemorrhage is one condition which, without prompt intervention, almost always results in very poor final vision. Suprachoroidal hemorrhage and subretinal hemorrhage can be coexistent entities. In elderly, it is mostly due to age-related macular degeneration and polyps. Our first patient was 62-year-old lady presenting with fresh submacular blood and a vision of finger counting close to face. It was a macroaneurysm. We injected perfluoropropane gas along with intravitreal 0.5 mg ranibizumab and tissue plasminogen activator. We followed it up with another 3 ranibizumab injections. The final vision improved to 6/18. The next patient was a 70-year-old lady. She presented with subfoveal hemorrhage and a visual acuity of finger counting close to face in her right eye. There was subretinal fresh and ochre blood. After vitrectomy and posterior vitreous detachment induction, we injected subretinal tissue plasminogen activator with little innovation. We broke one 26-gauge needle at the hub and fitted it tightly inside a 24-gauge needle. Intraoperative retinal bleeding was controlled with increased intraocular pressure and subsequent fluid gas exchange. The final vision was 6/60, which was satisfactory to patient. Then it was a 73-year-old gentleman who presented with right eye submacular hemorrhage with vitreous hemorrhage and a vision of finger counting. There were cluster polyps in indocyanine green angiography. After injection of ranibizumab and C3F8 gas, vision dropped to hand movement. There were increased vitreous hemorrhage, RPE rip, and inferior retinal detachment. We did a triamcinolone assisted pars plana vitrectomy and posterior vitreous detachment. Here we can see the rip and inferior detachment. Then we did a fluid gas exchange and filled the vitreous cavity with C3F8 gas. After 2 subsequent injections, the vision improved to 6/24. Last but not the least, there will be some patient with vitreous hemorrhage and organized subretinal blood. Here, after complete vitrectomy, temporal giant retinal tear was induced. The organized clot was dislodged and taken out. The bleeding was controlled and retina was reattached with not so bad final outcome. Worst of the cases may need pars plana vitrectomy and chorioretinal autologous transplant also. Timely intervention can provide good ambulatory vision and relief from an otherwise dreaded entity.